Niles. Niles.
I'm sorry, Fraser, but something horrible has happened. Maris kicked me out.
Dear God, why? What for?
Oh, my.
What's going on out there? Niles?
Hello, Dad.
Never mind, I don't want to know.
No, Dad, wait, there's a perfectly reasonable explanation for the way I'm dressed.
All right, just keep in mind that I reserve the right to say stop at any time.
Well, my plan was to leave a treasure map downstairs for Maris with clues that would lead her to my whereabouts. Then I'd hide in the linen closet and wait for her to find me.
Dressed like that?
Actually, no, at the time I was wearing only my eye patch. Although, technically, is it still an eye patch if you're wearing it on your...
Stop!
There I was, lying in wait with my little plastic knife clenched between my teeth, when suddenly the closet door was flung open and I found myself face to face with the upstairs maid. Well, she began screaming what I gather were some very unflattering things in idiomatic Guatemalan. When Maris stumbled upon the scene and completely misconstrued it. The next thing I knew, she ordered me out of the house. I barely had time to grab my pantaloons and buckle my swash. Dad. Dad, it's not funny.
Why'd you come up with such a stupid idea?
Fraser?
Look, all I suggested was some sexual role-playing. You're the one that came up with Pirates of the Caribbean.
Oh, I've really bungled it this time, haven't I?
Oh, come on. These things happen. Well, why don't you stay here tonight with us, and then tomorrow morning you and Maris can sort things out.
What if we don't? What'll I do then?
Well, I suppose they could always use an extra busboy at the Jolly Roger.
I'll never be able to face the maid again.
I don't think it's your face you'll remember. Oh, come on, Niles. Everybody has an embarrassing story to tell. Did I ever tell you about the time I got locked outside in the backyard in my underwear?
Only every Thanksgiving.
Well, don't worry, I won't be telling that story this year.